First of all, I want to acknowledge Speaker-elect Joseph Sakarchi, who was just here a second ago. I guess he stepped out. And I want to thank him for recognizing how important this meeting of House Oversight is to have at this point. And I'll get into that a little bit more in a second. We have been absent for quite a long time, and the general public has not incorrectly so admonished us for being absent. You're right, we should be here, we should be legislating, but as I said on another form of media this morning, we are family members as well, and some of us care for elderly, some people have underlying medical conditions, and I'm certainly not trying to make excuses. But we also sense the body, the increasing frustration and the level of, frankly, anger at the number of limitations that have been imposed upon Rhode Islanders. And this meeting of oversight was planned even before today's latest meeting with the governor and Dr. Alexander Scott. And I didn't get a chance to listen to all of it, but I know that there are some additional restrictions being placed upon us after today's meeting. And I would like the public to know that we share your frustration, we share your anxiety, and please remember that we are placed under the same restrictions as all of you. And the only other announcement I want to make is we are not here to criticize the governor or Dr. Alexander Scott. I think that they, speaking strictly for myself, I think that they did a very good job considering that they had no leadership from Washington. 50 governors were left to their own devices to do 50 things or to talk amongst themselves. So I think that the governor and her administration and Dr. Alexander Scott, I think that they really did a fine job in trying to keep us safe.